just had to put up with me singing at him. Would you please welcome Jay Morris? To have you back at this desk, and your new single, Wouldn't It Be Good, is pretty damn good. How does it feel to be releasing this new music?
It's great. It's definitely a summery feel song and a positive message in there too, you know. So, it's great, guys. You know, I'm independent now. I've done a full circle. I started independent with the major label for a long time. And back being independent, so it's good. This is my first track that's independent.
Is there more nerves that come with that?
Well, you can lose more money. So, yeah, you can be pretty nervous about that.
But you can also make more money.
You can make more money too.
Yeah, risk-reward. Exactly.
You're free from the man.
Look, I've always had a great relationship with the label anyway, so they've been great for me here, so there's no real complaints there. But I think it's just time, you know, it's a business decision to make that. And for me, I can do exactly what I want to do these days, you know.
It is a summery feel. It's a very happy feel. I'm not saying that your past music is dark and brooding, but it is a bit. And I'm wondering, why so happy, Pete Murray?
Well, not necessarily all... It's a bit, you know, a little bit dark in parts, but it's always got a positive message. And that's the thing, I think. I remember having an argument with some girl in Brisbane one time, but she's like, your music's depressing, you need to write something better. I'm going, Mitch, what song are you talking about, OK? Better Days. I said, Better Days is actually a positive song about getting through hard times and helping people. No, it's not. It's like, OK. Encourage people to do what they want to do and inspire people to follow their dreams, you know, so that's what I try to do.
Now you're heading out on tour. You're going to be heading up the coast or down the coast, around the coasts, doing shows all over summer. And I hear that there's also a chance for someone to have you in their backyard. I imagine doing a show, not just sort of like hiding in the bushes.
Yes.
The way you said that
kind of scared me right there. So 20 years ago I did this thing where I went and had a competition and I played in someone's backyard and they loved it so much. So I thought being independent again now, it's a way to just give back to my fans, and so we're putting this on. All you got to do is join up to my mailing list on my website and you get the chance of having me come play a gig in your backyard.
Well, you know, we've got quite a few audience members who I think would be very
how are you going to choose? What if the person's a psychopath?
I've just got to go. I just got to
handle itself.
It's so bad. 17.
A bit of karate, yeah.
Get beaten up by Pete Murray. Why not? 17 ARIA nominations, no wins. Who are these chumps at the ARIAs? What's going on there?
No, look, I love it. I love the fact that
it's
the record. And if I ever win one, that record won't exist. So
it's a badge of honour.
I'm effectively the biggest loser in the history of the ARIAs.
I don't think you're much of a loser. I actually am very jealous of you because in the early 2000s, I went and saw you at a bar in Sydney called the Gaelic Club. Yep. I don't know if you remember the show. You've probably done some better shows than that since then. But I was there with a person.
I do remember the show.
Really? Yeah. It was you and the Beautiful Girls and a bunch of other bands.
Yep.
And I was there with a person who would go on to be my girlfriend. I had a huge crush on them. And I remember looking at them during the show and thinking, oh my goodness, this person's so wonderful. This person's so beautiful. This person is so funny and cool and smart and just
you
perfect.
You said you wanted to spend the rest of your life with this person.
At the time, I was thinking that as well.
You're talking about and me. To me, this girl.
And then I saw her looking at you with the exact same look, and Pete Murray. That was a seminal moment for me where I realised that going to music shows is just bringing someone who you like closer to someone who's cooler than you. How do you respond to these allegations?
Well, I've grown a moustache, so that doesn't happen in the future. I'm attempting to drive home.
I do know that is for Movember, right?
It is.
But we've only had, 8 days? And so this is pretty good so far.
I'm actually starting to really like it. Yeah. I don't think my wife is, but I'm kind of, you know, we'll see how it goes. It's going to be a thick one, yeah.
Curiously Australian thing. Yeah. I've only been here for 3 years and, I mean, they're everywhere.
This is my first Mo.
Oh, really?
I've never had one before.
Okay, how are you finding it?
I like it. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, this is you shaving.
Is 8 days worth now.
Yeah.
Did you need to be shirtless for this scene?
I'm pretty sure that's how you shave moustaches.
Are you complaining, George and Tony?
Maybe you thought it was like you have to shave your whole body hair except that bit.
Makes it more special. If you shave the rest of the body, it makes it more special.
Yeah, the video got too long when I started getting down here, so I just cut it.
We got time for the ice bath? I don't know. There's a fridge of you in the ice bath.
We can just show the Olay.
Yeah, just from one ripped middle-aged man to another. Is this good for me?
Should we be doing
it? It is good for you. Yeah, it's hard work. Like, that is painful doing that. But
it's not painful for everyone. It's quite nice to look at.
You feel so good once you get out of it, that's for sure.
Tickets to Pete's Wouldn't It Be Good tour available now. Head to our website for all the details. Please thank Pete Murray.